If you've played Spyro Hero's Tale, there's a strange oddity you might have noticed when teleporting, particularly if you've played the game in stereo, and it's that the sound seems a bit wrong. Sometimes it sounds fine, but many times you'll notice that it only plays from either your left or right speaker. Why is that? Is that some weird bug? Well, I decided to analyze this particular sound, and thankfully we have some powerful tools to do so. This is Eurosound Explorer, a program used by Eurocom for analyzing sound banks and music files for their games, recreated from scratch by the excellent Jay Marty. Here we see all the sound banks in the game, as well as the stream bank. The sound we're looking for is a streamed sound referenced by the generic sound bank, so we'll load both stream data and SB generic. In here we'll find an SFX called SFX Gen HUD Loading. Most SFX consist of one or more samples and a bunch of parameters for how the sound is played back. Loading up the SFX, we see three samples. I'll play them for you now. You'll notice that two of these samples, specifically those swirling noises, are panned all the way left and right respectively, while the third one is a windy, whooshy noise that isn't panned. If we look at the settings for this SFX, we can see that it's set to pick a random one of these whenever the SFX is activated. This is exactly what we experienced in the game. Sometimes a whoosh noise is played from the middle, and sometimes the swirling noise is played from either all the way left or all the way right. So this is not a bug, it's exactly how the sound was configured, but why is it made like this? It seems like an odd decision to me, and I do wonder if it was meant to be like this. Maybe the two panned swirling noises were meant to play simultaneously, to create a stereo effect, given that they're slightly different from each other. This isn't too far-fetched an idea. The game's title sequence has sounds that are just two stream samples played at the same time, panned left and right, to create stereo sound effects. The whooshy, windy noise might have been meant as a layer on top of this stereo sound. We may never truly know whether this configuration was intentional or not. But, out of curiosity, let's edit the sound to play how I described, and see how it sounds in-game. We can do this using the Eurosound Editor, another Eurocom tool recreated by Jay Marty, which lets us edit the sound banks and put them back into the game. Let's open the SFX from before and change the settings from single to multi-sample, and make it polyphonic so all the sound effects play at once. I'll also lower the volume a bit to make it less intense. Here's what it sounds like in-game. I'd say that doesn't sound too bad. Perhaps the developers thought it sounded a little busy, and so made a quick fix by just making it play one of the samples instead of all at once. Or perhaps they just accidentally changed the setting and didn't notice before release. Let me know in the comments what you think. Anyway, that's about all I have for this video. Thanks to Jay Marty for all these wonderful tools that let us analyze and edit the sound of this game in all sorts of fun ways. You can check the GitHub for all his tools down in the description. Thanks for watching.